made the people in Syria, a lot of Syrians you see, they look white.
Yep.
Babylon, which is Iraq, Assyria, yep. Persia, India, and parts of Arabia much lighter in complexion. It says now, the color of the people in this region ranges from brown to yellow.
See?
The Greek and Roman invasions also made these people in the Middle East lighter.
That's right, man.
Another fact we should not forget is that the Moors and Arabs from North Africa captured and raped European women. That came to my mind.
But yeah, it's beautiful. Flip side. Yeah, that was the flip side of it.
It says, as a result, the North Africans became lighter. It says, yeah, that was basically the point.
Khan, that was beautiful, man. The water.
Yeah. So you have more?
Yeah, Khan. It says, behold, the day has come, said the Lord, that the plowman shall overtake the reaper and the treader of grapes, him that sowed seed, and the mountain shall drop sweet wine, and all the hills shall melt, and I will bring again the captivity of my people of Israel, and they shall build the way cities.
So Slucky, brother, it says we shall overthrow, that the plowman shall overtake the reaper.
Okay.
Alright, so we're gonna overtake these devils, man.
Okay.
Right now we're doing it through the scriptures, through the word. Alright? But we're actually going to overtake the devils, man. Physically. When the Most High gives us green light. When he gives us the power.
Mm-hmm.
And it's through the power of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Right? Not the power of your gun. Alright? Not the power of men. Not the power of organization. Alright? Like you got Nate talking about, we're organized nation. Right?
Yep. And I will bring again the captivity of my people of Israel, and they shall build away cities and inhabit them.
Yep.
And they shall plant vineyards and drink the vine thereof.
Hey, like, because when we were enslaved, when you planted vineyards, guess who reaped the grapes? Esau. He reaped the grapes, and then they crushed the grapes, they made the wine. You didn't drink up the wine.
Nope.
All right, and then even after slavery, okay, the white man gave you some land to till. You had to give a percentage of that back to the devil. All right, and then, to make matters worse, the Most High made it to where the first fruits went to Esau. The rest that you kept, the Most High swept it away through the blasting in Deuteronomy 28. He made that cold frost to basically freezer burn your food, your crops. All right, he made locusts come and eat it up. So you were totally destroyed, man. All right, go ahead.
Yep, it says, and inhabit them, they shall plant vineyards and drink the vine thereof. And they shall plant vineyards and drink the vine thereof. And they shall also make gardens and eat the fruit of them.
Mm-hmm.
And I will plant them up on their land, and they shall no more be pulled up out of their land which I have given them, said the Lord thy God.
That's right. So the Most High is going to plant us in Israel, and we're not going to be rooted out, basically. All right, because, man, from Joshua, all right, we had the land, all right, when we killed the Canaanites, right, and all of their sons, you had the Girgashites, the Hivites, the Amorites, all right, but then when you read Judges, we went through different captivities, man. You know, then the first big one was the Assyrian captivity, man. When we lost basically Samaria, all right, because the Assyrians overthrew Samaria, but the Most High made it to where they didn't overthrow Judah, because the Most High took out, what was it, 720,000 Assyrians,
mm-hmm,
with the angel of death, man. But then guess what? Judah was still being wicked. The Most High brought the Babylonians on them. That's when we went into captivity, man. All right, that's where Ezra picks up. You had the Persians,
mm-hmm,
after the Persian Medo Empire, Medo-Persian Empire. You had Cyrus, Darius, right? After that, you had the Greeks, man, which we were kind of going on and off with the Maccabees, but it was basically by the skin of your teeth, man. It was very close, you know. We were always it was never peaceful, basically. The only real peace we had in the land of Israel was with King Solomon. Was it 40 years? After that, it was either we were going off and we were fighting with the nations around us, or we were beefing with amongst ourselves, man.
I know that scripture.
You know? But
Deuteronomy chapter 7. When the Lord thy God shall bring thee into the land to go possess it, and cast out many nations before thee.
Yep.
The Hittites, the Girgashites, the Amorites, the Canaanites, and the Perizzites, the Avaritites, and the Jebusites.
So all those nation that he read, those are all sons of Canaan. Those are all Canaanites. Okay, the Girgashites, the Amorites. When you go to Genesis 10, those are all sons of Canaan. Go ahead.
Seven nations greater and mighty than thou.
Mm-hmm.
And when the Lord thy God shall deliver them before them, thou shalt smite them and utterly destroy them.
Yep.
Thou shalt make no covenant with them, neither show mercy on them,
yep.
Neither shall make no marriage with them.
Yep.
Thy daughter, thou shalt not give unto his son, and his daughter shall thou take unto thy son, for they will turn away thy son from following me. They will serve other gods. So will the anger of the Lord will kindle against you and destroy thee suddenly. But thou shall ye deal with them, ye shall destroy the altar and break down the grove and graven image and burn it with fire. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people upon the face of the earth. See that?
Yes. I got a precept.
Go ahead.
That would be Acts 7 and 45. So Acts 7 and 45. It says, which also our fathers that came after, before, in with Yehoshua into the possession of the Gentiles, whom the Most High power drove out before the face of our fathers unto the days of David.
Mm-hmm.
And verse 46 says,
because David was fighting the Hamites, man.
That's right.
His most hated enemies were the Hamites, the Philistines.
Mm-hmm.
All right, that's what he was trying to, because the Philistines were basically north of Israel. All right, it was on the coast. That's what David was trying to conquer, man. All right, Goliath himself was a Philistine. All right, go ahead.
Verse 46, who found favor before the Most High power and desired to find a tabernacle for the Most High, for the power of the Most High of Jacob. And verse 47 says, but Solomon built him an house. Howbeit the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands,
mm-hmm.
as saith the prophet.
That was it?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay.
I have something. This is Joel 3 and 1. For behold, in those days and in that time when I shall bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem, I will also gather all nations, and I will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat, and I will plead with them there for my people and for my heritage Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations and parted my land. And they have cast lots for my people and have given a boy for an harlot and sold a girl for wine, that they might drink.
Hey, and that's a beautiful thing, man. But this is exactly what our people are running away from. They're running away from that war, you know, because we're prophesying war that's coming. And then that's what our people don't like. But read that again. Read it from the top again.
Joel 3 and 1.
Mm-hmm.
For behold, in those days and in that time when I shall bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem, I will also gather all nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat, and will plead with them there for my people and for my heritage Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations and parted my land. And they have cast lots for my people and have given a boy for an harlot.
So you see why it's going to happen? It's going to happen because of that wickedness that they did to us. Right? What the brother is describing right there, them casting lots, that's slavery. That's them selling Israelites.
Yes.
right? That's why the scripture that I was going to get, Jeremiah 2 and 11, right? Where it says, have a nation changed their gods? And it says, is Israel a homeborn slave? Because our people, all they know is slavery, man. All these people know is slavery. So all they know is slavery. That's all they're used to is slavery. You know, they have Stockholm syndrome, man.
Yeah.
All these people know is slavery. That's why when you tell them what we're talking about, they say we're radical. Nothing about this is radical. Everything that we're talking is righteous, man. This is all righteous.
That's right.
Because read it again. Let's get into it again. Because the Most High is telling you something that he's going to do, and then he's letting you know why he's going to do it, man. Read it again.
Joel 3 and 1. For behold, in those days, and in that time when I shall bring again the
captive. Yo, and we're in that time right now. That's why the prophets are on the highways and byways now. That's why you have brothers like this, like you see, making videos, man, and putting it up on YouTube on a daily basis, man. You guys can't stop the brothers from putting up videos, man. The internet was made for the brothers to be a nuisance onto you, man. To annoy you all day, every single day, man. And you know what? We work at your jobs, and guess what? You know that we're the Israelites. We hide it from you, but you know there's something in your spirit that lets you know that there's something different about this friggin' Negro that I'm working with. He's not like a regular Negro that I've ever worked with. This Latino is not like a regular Latino I've ever worked with. This Native American is not a regular Native American that I've worked. You devils know that we know that we're the Israelites. There's just something in their spirit that lets them know that we know the truth, man. Because we don't act like a regular nigga or a regular Israelite. We carry ourselves with more decency, man. More upright. We have more knowledge than your average. Which is all a blessing from Yah Bashim Yahushai. It's not according to us, man. I guarantee you that. Because I was just a regular nigga before I came into this truth. Right? Go ahead.
And in that time when I shall bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem, I will also gather all the nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat.
So this is a blessing. When the Most High told us to tell our people this, our people should be rejoicing. Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai. They should be praising the Heavenly Father, man. They should be praising the Heavenly Father that he raised us up and has us out on the highways and byways, telling them that he's coming again, man. Because you've been in slavery so damn long, the only thing you should be waiting for is your Savior. By now,
I represent that. That's
right. Right now, you shouldn't be waiting on the on your next what's the check coming out in February?
The family payment.
The end of the year check.
GST check.
Income tax. Lock it. Your income tax. Every nigga's waiting on the income tax check. I used to be in the world, man. I know this, man. It's the end of the year. Niggas can't wait to do their income tax.
I don't even get any more income tax.
Right? That's not the point. The point is that niggas are waiting on income tax check, and this is where they praise Esau. You know why? Because Esau gives them a little
crumb
to water, brother. Exactly. Gives them a little crumb.
And that's what the brothers mentioned is Stockholm Syndrome, man, because Stockholm is, where the hell is that? Northern Europe, I forget
Sweden.
What country. Sweden, to Sweden. It was a bank robbery, basically, and they held them for, was it 2 or 3 days?
Yeah.
And they became so dependent on him.
I have it right here.
That, yeah, you got it? Yeah, bring it out.
Yeah, bring it out, man. Yeah, we don't bring it out. That's beautiful, yeah. We always talk about it. We don't bring it out.
This is Stockholm Syndrome, and, on Wikipedia, better yet, Wikipedia, this is the history. It says Stockholm Syndrome is named after Normla Starch.
Speak of Oxlack.
It says here, Stockholm Syndrome is named after the Norma Stodge robbery in Credit Banken at Normla Stodge in Stockholm, Sweden, in which several bank employees were held hostage in a bank vault from August 23rd to the 28th, that's 5 days, 1973, while their captors negotiated with police during this standoff, the victims became emotionally attached to the captors.
Hey, brother, can I say something?